court. And that happened just before his marriage in 1759. He married a widow, Martha Danrich Custis. They raised her children from her previous marriage. They didn't have any children of their own. Next came the South Wing on that side. That was the mid-1770s. And the North Wing was completed by 1787, that wing that we'll be going in. We're going to be starting in the Servants' Hall today. That building right behind this gardener's house was built in 1775, and it was for white servants, like coachmen, valet, butlers, that came here with the visitors back then. In 1798, in 1 year, they had 677 overnight stays. So we'll continue into what he called the new room, the North Wing. And that was a multi-purpose space for formal receptions, dancing, concerts. And in that room on the far wall facing the river is a reproduction of the harpsichord that he purchased for his step-granddaughter Nellie. And you'll hear piped-in music from that harpsichord, won't you?
Expanded it to 8,000 acres.
Okay. And today, so right now, how many acres is
right
this?
Right now, it's less than 500, a little less than 500.
Yeah.
Of course, a lot of it's just to protect the view, like across that road there, that's Mount Vernon too, but can't build on it. Just like some of the areas around here, like where the library is built and stuff.
So he died at 67, right? And she died at 70, and they you said she's 8 months difference?
Older. About 26, 27.
So yeah. She married young. With
what?
She married pretty young with her first husband.
That was very common back then.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You know how old she was when she got married the first time?
She was in her teens.
Yeah.
Because she had four children with her first husband.
Uh-huh.
And then she's turning around and marrying again when she's 26 or 27 again. So
you say she was a widower. I mean, so
what?
Her first husband passed away?
He died. He was like 20 years older than her. I don't know if he had a heart attack or what, but he died very suddenly.
So he must have died pretty young. In his
40s. 40 or so. Between 40 and 50, yeah. 317 slaves here altogether. Uh-huh. 153 were dower or custis slaves, and there were 41 rented or leased slaves, apart from a land deal he had with the Mrs. French.
Yeah, so, and he freed all of them afterwards?
Only the ones he owned. He didn't own the others.
Go south 100 miles. So here's about a mile across. 100 miles south, the river will open up to about 10 miles wide and fill into the Chesapeake Bay. Another 100 miles through the Chesapeake Bay, Ryan, what ocean are we in? You are right, we're in the Atlantic Ocean, meaning you can sail from here to England, France, Spain, Portugal, Scotland, Ireland. Washington never went to Europe. Only out-of-country trip he took was to Barbados, the West Indies, with his older half-brother Lawrence. Lawrence had tuberculosis, and they thought the warmer climate would help. Sadly, it didn't. Very interesting, when he was down there, Washington contracted smallpox. He survived it. He becomes immune to it. And it saved his life during the Revolutionary War. So yeah, this river, lots of fishing going on, shad and herring. He had docks here. And all we have not a whole bunch of river traffic. Sometimes we have some little private boats. We'll get a couple of little small ships. Sometimes a Coast Guard ship will pass here. Sometimes a Navy ship. And when the military ships pass here, they actually salute. They'll fire a cannon and they'll salute. And they'll usually play a bugle call like taps to honor General Washington. You know, Washington had lots of dogs, by the way. He had foxhounds, he had Newfies, Dalmatians, rat terriers in the basement. But the fox hunts were really big. And there were other gatherings and outings. Keep in mind, he also traveled a lot. So he owns Mount Vernon for about 40-something years, 45. But he's away over 16 years. Where's he president? Not in Washington, D.C., because we didn't have a Washington, D.C. yet. He was president in New York when he's inaugurated April 3rd, 1789, Federal Hall, Manhattan, Wall Street. Then the Capitol moves to Philadelphia. Two terms as president, that's 8 years. And then the Revolutionary War, he's away. Trenton, Princeton, Morristown, Monmouth, Cambridge, Valley Forge, Georgetown, Boston. That's about 8.5 years. Even though the war ends in 81, it's not officially over until 1783, when they signed the treaty.